Hello and welcome to More Fractional Exponents. I knew you'd be wanting more. Here it comes. With fractional exponents, remember we're talking about changing things from an exponent to a radical or from a radical form to an exponent. Here's some examples that are worth looking at that give some people trouble sometimes. Simplify using exponents. If I have the root here of x to the fourth. The first thing is that if there's no number here, remember it's automatically a 2, it's automatically a square root. So if I want to change this then to exponents, remember that this is going to be x to the, this number is what's making it bigger, it's going to go in the numerator. This number is the root, it's making it smaller. So x to the 4 over 2 power. But then we want to take a moment and say, wait a second, can I simplify or reduce 4 over 2? What's 4 divided by 2? That is 2. So I should write this one as x squared. Okay? Now this one, x to the 5th, very similar. We would say this is x to the 5 over 2 power. And if our directions were just to leave it with exponents, then we are done. This is the simplified form. We could say, well, that's the same as 2.5, so really it's the same as 2.5, but in our mathematical way of doing things, this is not the simplified version with exponents, this is the simplified version with exponents. Now, that said, if this was the problem and the directions were simplify using radicals, then we'd want to think about it like this. Well, we can get 2 goes into 5 2 whole times with 1 left over. So if I was going to only put this into radical form, this part wouldn't need to be in a radical because it's just x squared. The only part that would need to be in a radical is this. And this would be the square root of x to the first. So if the directions were starting with this and saying simplify using radicals, we would have this as our final answer here because we know it goes in 2 whole times with 1 left over in the radical. I wanted to clarify that. So what if you've got two pieces together? 16x to the 6th. If the directions were to simplify using radicals, very easy, we would take this and that separately. So the first one is 16 to the 1/2 power and the second part is x to the 6/2 power, but we're not quite done. We know what 16 to the 1/2 is. That is the square root of 16. That is 4. And we know what x to the 6 over 2 power is because 6 divided by 2 is 3. When it works out nice and evenly, we can just put 4x to the 3rd. This one, same thing. We've got 16 to the 1/2 power and x to the 7/2 power. If the directions were to simplify using exponents, we would be fine to just leave it like this. If the directions said simplify using radicals, which it does sometimes, then this part we would need to readjust a little bit. 2 goes into 7 3 times with 1 left over. So if we were asked to put it in radical form, we would write it 4x to the 3rd, which is all plain. And then this is the only part that would need to be in the radical, okay? So I wanted to clarify that. It depends on what the directions are asking, but that's kind of how we can work with them back and forth. Okay, here's something to take care of. How are these two problems different? 4x to the 2/3, 4x to the 2/3, they sound the same, but they are different. If we were to write them using a radical, in this one, the only part that's being raised to the 2/3 is the x. So the 4 can stay along for the ride. This needs to change the cube root of x squared. But in this one, it's all being raised to the 2/3 power, so the 4 is part of the radical. We would say the cube root of all of this 4x being squared. Or we could write it as cube root of 4x all squared. We know those two forms are equivalent. But in this one, the 4 is not part of the radical, so don't put it in. In this part, it is. Here's a problem where we've got x's and y's together, and it says change this to a single radical. So we're trying to find some kind of radical that would work for everything. And if you notice, when a problem is like this, if we have common denominators, that is very good because they are both having a root of 5. So we can make it the fifth root together of x to the second and y to the third. So if you see multiple things together, look to make common denominators so we can make one root. Lastly, let's take a look at problems that have negative exponents. If the directions are to simplify using radicals, something like this, remember, I never want you doing power to power with a negative exponent if there's a coefficient here, because that's going to mess it up. What does the negative exponent actually mean? It means reciprocal, remember? So it's going to drop into the denominator. So this means to the positive 1/2. So I've dealt with the negative. Now I'm just going to use my radicals, and I need to put this into a radical form, so I know the 1/2 power is the same as the square root of 5xy. And I don't really need to write that too. If it's a square root, it's okay to leave it as it is. In this problem, there's no coefficient here, so I actually could kind of deal with this. There's a fast way and there's a slow way here. I'll show you two different ways. We could deal with this first, like I talk about. So we could put this in the denominator, keeping everything here the same, but just changing this to positive. Then we could slide this back up to the numerator and go x to the 1/2 over 1 to the 8th, and then go power to power and say 1/2 times 8 is 4. That is all legit. However, in this problem, the fastest way to deal with this, since there's no coefficient here, we could just take power to power right off the bat. Negative 1/2 times negative 8 is just 4. So this is equal to x to the 4th. There's a little faster way. Last problem for today. Again, we have a negative exponent. But since I have a coefficient, I do not want to do power to power yet. I'd like to sort this out. The negative exponent means it drops into the denominator. The whole thing is to the 1/2 power. 1/2 power means the square root. Square root of 9x. And I'm almost done, but I want to look in these situations to see, wait a second, is there anything here that I know? Do I know the square root of 9? This means the square root of 9 times the square root of x. Do I know the square root of 9? Yes, I do. That is 3. So let's not leave this as the square root of 9 when I could write it as 3. This is still square root of x, there's nothing I can do with that. So we'll go 3 and the square root of x. I hope this is helpful. I know you like more negative exponents, and you are welcome. Have a great day.